Hello guys, good morning. I am Santosh Singh and today we are going to see how many way pass a password in Apache Sqoop. So let's see these things and welcome to my channel. So there are three way to pass password in Sqoop import command. First we can pass using hyphen hyphen password space my password, and second we can do hyphen capital P, and third we can do by reading password from a file. So in hyphen hyphen password space my password, specify the password on the command line with this parameter, and in second when we use hyphen capital P then read password from console, and third when we read password from a file. Why we read password from a file? When we are typing syntax on command line, then there is possibility that anyone can see the password while typing. So for security perspective, it is a good idea to read password from a file. So let's see these things one by one in detail. So first we are going to see hyphen hyphen password space my password. So this is a common way to pass database password in Sqoop. This is a common way, as we have seen these things so many times. This is a very common way and we have implemented these things so many times, but this is very insecure way, as other user may be able to read your password from the command line argument. So following way we can give password in Sqoop command. So this is the Sqoop command, and like this way we can give the password by specifying hyphen hyphen password space my password. It means it is the MySQL password. When we press enter, then it will list the databases of MySQL. So like this way we have seen that how hyphen hyphen password space password use in Sqoop. We have seen these things so many times. So now let's see the next things. Next things is how we use hyphen capital P in Sqoop. So instruct Sqoop to read the password from standard input. The hyphen capital P argument is preferred method over using the hyphen hyphen password argument. So it is a better way to pass a password than hyphen hyphen password, because in hyphen hyphen password anyone can see the password, but in this you type password but no one can see. So let's see the example. This is the example of passing password by hyphen P argument. So as we can see, Sqoop space list hyphen databases space hyphen hyphen connect space JDBC colon MySQL double forward slash localhost space hyphen hyphen username space root space hyphen capital P, and when we press enter then it will prompt for password. When we run the above Sqoop command, then it will prompt for password on console as following. So when we hit enter, then it will ask password like that, enter password, and when we type password then it is hidden, as you might seen in Linux that when we type password then it is invisible. When we type password by using hyphen P, so it is invisible. So now let's see the third option. Third option is reading password from a file. So reading password from a file, set a file containing the authentication password. We need to set a file. The file which we set, that file will have a password, a correct password. So this is the example that how we can use password file. Suppose we are going to import student table, then we can use like this, Sqoop space import space hyphen hyphen connect space JDBC colon MySQL colon double forward slash localhost slash cells and space hyphen hyphen username space root space hyphen hyphen password hyphen file space my sqoop password. So it is the file. This is the file, and we can specify here the path of file and hyphen hyphen table space student. So this sqoop command import the student table. Today session we have seen that how we pass password in sqoop, and we have seen that we can pass password by three way. First, by using hyphen hyphen username space MySQL username, and second hyphen capital P, and when we press enter then it will ask you password, but that password will be invisible. And third, by using hyphen hyphen password hyphen file, and we can specify the path of that file. So sqoop read password from this file. So this is all about. Thanks for sharing your time with me.